The Airbus A350-1000 and the Boeing 777X are the largest twin-engine jet aircraft in the sky. The latter should have entered into service by now, but repeated delays have meant that the first deliveries are currently scheduled for 2023. With long-haul demand predicted to partially recover by then, could Airbus revisit the idea of an A350-2000 to compete against Boeing's new flagship? Once upon a time, about 5 years ago, Airbus hinted it could be looking at a further stretch of its A350 to challenge Boeing's forthcoming 777X. If kept within specific parameters, it's an entirely feasible project and one that wouldn't even require too much re-engineering. A 4-meter stretch of the fuselage from its current 73.88 meters would keep the plane within the limit of 4 pairs of exit doors. This would add another 4 rows and 45 seats. Furthermore, according to estimates from Liam News at the time, it would only increase the maximum takeoff weight, or MTOW, by 11 tons, keeping it within the thrust capabilities of current Rolls-Royce XWB engines. A potential stretched A350 would also have an empty weight of about 25 tons less than the 777-9, making it an attractive alternative from the point of view of fuel consumption. Adding 45 more seats to an average layout of the A350 would take it from approximately 370 seats to 415, competing with the 777-9's 406 to 425 passenger range. At the time, Airbus's former chief operating officer for customers, John Leahy, told Flight Global that despite his initial skepticism toward the project, there appeared to be a growing interest from airlines. "I'm the one that started out with probably the most skepticism of, is there really a market for 45 more seats?" Leahy said during the ISTAT Americas conference in February 2016. "Now I think there is some market." Leahy then added that he was just about to go to lunch with the representative of an operator to discuss a potential A350 stretch. A few years later, the plane maker's CEO, Guillaume Faury, toned down any discussions on an A350-2000. Despite the A380 program coming to an end, Airbus, at least in 2019, had no intentions of increasing the size of its continued wide-body offering. "So we made the first priority to try to find another way to serve this capacity. We're happy with the A350-900 and 1000, so we keep focusing on those versions of the plane." Initially, the A350-1000 was approved for 440 seats. However, in December 2019, EASA gave the green light for Airbus to add an extra 40 seats to the aircraft's max capacity, following the installation of modified emergency exits. Not many airlines operate the A350 at its higher capacity range. For example, Cathay Pacific fits 334 in 3 classes, including premium economy. However, leisure operator French B has taken the challenge, packing in 480 seats into its newly received A350-1000. In considering a stretched A350, there are other engineering issues to think about than adding pieces to the fuselage. For instance, the 777X has a wing that is 106 feet long. However, when its wingtip is unfolded, it stretches to a massive 117 feet. The Airbus A350 wing is 105 feet. An extended version of the A350 could potentially also entail a re-engineering of the wing. Meanwhile, in 2018, Airbus's chief operating officer Fabrice Brégier also said that Airbus would only consider an A350-2000 once engine capacity developed further. For now, the plane maker will focus on the 2 variants it already has, the -900 and the -1000. Brégier drew parallels to Boeing's development of the 787 Dreamliner program, beginning with the -8 and the -9, before adding the stretched -10 version several years later. There is extra potential that was extracted by Boeing on the 787 and which is still present for us to capture in the next 4 or 5 years, Brégier told Flight Global at the time. "Then we will see, and probably when there is a new generation of engines, we'll be able to question whether we can stretch again the A350. The good news is that we've studied it and it is possible," he continued. What do you think? Should Airbus launch a 777X competitor? Is there enough of a market in the current conditions? What would it take to be an economic success? Leave a comment in the section below and join the conversation. In addition to our daily YouTube videos, Simple Flying publishes over 150 articles and a podcast every week. If you're looking for the latest aviation news and insights, visit simpleflying.com. Thanks for watching, and don't forget to like and subscribe before you go.